Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is your instructor Anisa Nawaz from Department of Physics. This is our lecture number 17 from chapter number 2, Vectors and Equilibrium. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about product of vectors, that how we are going to multiply two vectors, dot product, that how we are going to multiply two vectors to get a scalar quantity, and some characteristics of dot or scalar product. In this lecture, we will discuss about the other way of multiplying two vectors, which is cross product. Okay, so after this lecture, we will be able to understand what is cross product or vector product. As we have already discussed this thing, that when we are going to multiply two vectors, if we are getting a result as a scalar, then this will be known as scalar or dot product. And if we are going to get the result as a vector, that will be known as vector or cross product. This is what we are going to discuss in this lecture, vector or cross product. Okay, so when a vector is multiplied by a vector and the result obtained is a vector quantity, such type of vector multiplication is called vector product. Vector multiplied by vector is equal to a vector. Okay, we are going to multiply two vectors and the result is a vector quantity. Okay, so the cross product, let's say we are having two vectors, vector A and vector B. And the cross product A cross B of two vectors A and B, unlike the dot product, is a vector. If we are going to multiply two vectors and we are getting a result which is a vector quantity, this will be known as the cross product. Okay, for this reason it is also called the vector product. Okay, we are having two vectors which are multiplied to give us a vector quantity, because sometimes we need such quantities which should result in a scalar, and sometimes we need such quantities which should result in a vector. So whenever we need a vector quantity in resultant, we use this cross product. Okay, so the vector A cross B is orthogonal to both vector A and B. The result which we will obtain, we said that it is a vector quantity, so that vector should be perpendicular, should be orthogonal to both A and B. Okay, we will see how this is possible. We will check this out. Okay, so let vector A and vector B be represented by arrows with the same initial point as shown. You can see over here, let's say that we are having two vectors, vector A and vector B. And just like in scalar product, we have joined these two vectors from their tails. We are using the same thing over here. Okay, we are joining vector A and vector B from their tails, and theta is the smaller of the angle between the two. You can see one theta is here and other theta could be this one. Okay, this whole angle could be the theta, but we are not considering that, because by definition of theta for product of vectors, we should consider angle which is smaller of the two angles, okay, which is always between 0 and 180 degrees, not greater than that. Okay, so we are taking the angle between 0 and 180 degrees, smaller of the two angles. So this is vector A, this is vector B, and we have to take cross product of these two vectors. Okay, so if we are going to multiply these two products, these two vectors, in such a way that we need a vector which should be a which should be perpendicular to both the vectors, then how it is done? It is stated that the cross product A cross B points in a direction perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. We should be having a resultant vector which is perpendicular to both the vectors A and B. You can see over here, this is vector A, this is vector B. Both vectors are joined by their tails. Theta is the smaller of the angles between the two vectors. We are having a vector A cross B which is making an angle 90 degrees with vector B and 90 degrees with vector A. Okay, so this resultant vector A cross B is such a vector which is perpendicular to the plane containing vector A and vector B. Okay, for example, if vector A and B are in XY plane, then vector resultant vector A cross B must be in Z plane. Okay, so we should be having the resultant in such a way that it is perpendicular to the plane containing both the vectors to be multiplied. Okay, keep this in mind. This is the direction of resultant vector, that if you are going to multiply two vectors by cross product, then resultant should be such that it is perpendicular to the plane containing vectors A and vector B. Okay, so it turns out that the direction of vector A cross B is given by the right hand rule as follows. We will follow a rule to find out the direction of resultant, which is known as right hand rule. We have to use right hand for this, not left hand. Okay, we have to use right hand for this rule. What does this rule state? Right hand rule. If the fingers of your right hand curl in the direction of rotation through an angle less than 180 degrees from vector A to vector B, then your thumb, erect thumb, points in the direction of A cross B. Okay, it is also called screw rule. Another name for right hand rule is screw rule. Okay, so what we will do? We will curl the fingers of our right hand. Okay, place your right hand, draw the vectors, place your right hand, curl the fingers of right hand in the direction of rotation. For example, if we are finding A cross B, then we will place our fingers along A and we will curl the fingers of right hand along the direction of B. Okay, we will curl the fingers from A to B, direction of rotation, because it is A cross B. Keep this in mind, there is a difference between A cross B and B cross A. Right now we are finding out A cross B, so we will curl our fingers of right hand from A to B. Then this erected thumb, it will point in the direction of resultant vector, which is A cross B. Okay, this is known as right hand rule. If we will curl the fingers of right hand along the direction of rotation, then thumb will indicate the direction of the resultant. Okay, this is also known as screw rule. Okay, so we know the direction of the resultant vector A cross B. The remaining thing we need to complete its geometrical description is length of A cross B. Okay, what about the magnitude? What about the length of A cross B? Okay, so if we say that theta is the angle between vector A and B, theta is between 0 and pi, 0 and 180 degrees, then we can say that the cross product, it is having a formula: A, magnitude of vector A, magnitude of B, sine of angle between them with a unit vector. Okay, this unit vector is important here because we have defined the cross product as a vector quantity. So for its complete description, we need magnitude as well as direction. For its complete description, magnitude as well as direction is needed. Okay, so without this n hat, this definition is incomplete. AB sine of theta is just telling us about the magnitude, and n hat is basically telling us about the direction of resultant vector, the vector which is normal to the plane containing A and B. So for complete description of A cross B, we need magnitude as well as direction. Okay, and this theta, sine of theta, basically theta is smaller of the angle between A and B, and sine theta is basically the perpendicular component. Okay, so if we again define this cross product in terms of component, then how we are going to define it? The product of magnitude of one vector to the component of second vector perpendicular to the first vector. Okay, in dot product we have considered such a component which was along the first vector. Right now we need the component of second vector which is perpendicular to the first vector. Okay, more this component, more perpendicular vector component is there, more effective value of cross product is. Okay, you can see over here we are having two vectors, vector A and vector B. We are joining these two vectors from their tails. You can see over here we are joining these two vectors from their tails. Okay, and then we will drop the perpendicular from vector B, and then we will consider its vertical component B sine theta. Okay, now what will happen if we are going to find out the cross product? This cross product will be equal to magnitude of vector A complete magnitude of vector A multiplied by perpendicular component of vector B, B sine theta. We will multiply vector A and vector B. Okay, where it is needed, we will see that in applications. Okay, so we are having vector A and vector B. More the vertical component, more will be the magnitude of this cross product. Okay, you can consider the example of mouth of a crocodile. If it is more opened, more effective value is there. Okay, more vertical component is there, and this n hat is basically the direction of resultant vector. Okay, so product of magnitude of one vector to the component of second vector perpendicular to the first vector, this is another definition of cross product. Okay, so what is vector n hat? N hat is a unit vector which gives direction of A cross B. N hat, it is a unit vector which is telling us about the direction of A cross B. Okay, and N hat points in a direction perpendicular to the plane containing vector A and vector B. So N hat, what is N hat? It is a unit vector. Unit vector means vector of magnitude 1. Its magnitude is 1. So multiplying this vector with the magnitude does not change the magnitude of the resultant. It is just telling us about the direction of A cross B. Okay, and without n hat, the definition of A cross B is incomplete. Okay, so you can see over here, let's say that we are having two vectors, let's say this blue and red, these two vectors are there, and this green vector is representing the resultant vector A cross B. If you are going to multiply these two vectors, you can see that we are changing the angle, we are changing the angle, and magnitude and direction of the resultant is changing. Okay, so you can see over here, if two vectors are exactly parallel, cross product is zero. If vector this angle is increasing, if this angle is increasing in positive direction, A cross B magnitude is increasing. At 90 degrees it is maximum. Okay, and if it is increasing from 180 degrees, you can see over here direction of vector product is changed, because now we will take angle on this side. Okay, let's see how this is done. You can see over here, if we are having two vectors, vector A and B, and when they were at this perpendicular, A and B were perpendicular, magnitude of A cross B was maximum. When vector A and vector B were at 90 degrees, both were antiparallel, then product will be zero, because sine of 180 is zero. Okay, if it is changed now, then now we have to curl the fingers and thumb will point in the downward direction. A is perpendicular to B, again magnitude would be same, but what will happen? Direction will be opposite. And again, if A and B are parallel, product will be zero, sine of zero is zero. Okay, you can see it again, if two vectors are perpendicular to each other, cross product is maximum. Okay, magnitude of A, B and sine of 90 is 1, then what will happen? When both are antiparallel, sine of 180 is zero, cross product will be zero. If it is now in this direction, right hand will point in the downward direction, thumb will point in the downward direction, magnitude will be maximum, but direction will be opposite. And again, if two vectors are parallel, then what will happen? Cross product will again be zero. Okay, so a vector is completely determined by its magnitude as well as direction. You know that the definition of vector is incomplete. Except if we are not going to define its magnitude as well as direction, then its definition is incomplete. Thus, we can now say that A cross B is a vector that is perpendicular to both vector A and B, whose orientation is determined by right hand rule, and length is magnitude of A into magnitude of B into sine theta. So now it is proved that vector A cross B is basically a vector quantity. A cross B is giving us a resultant which is a vector. Its direction, its orientation can be determined by right hand rule, and its magnitude, its length is AB sine of theta. Okay, again repeating same thing, that this symbol bars and arrowhead, this is equivalent to simple A. You can either write A or you can write this notation to represent the magnitude. Okay, so now it is proved that A cross B is a vector quantity. The cross product of two vectors says something about how perpendicular they are. Okay, dot product was telling us about how parallel two vectors are. Cross product is telling us about how perpendicular two vectors are, because if two vectors are perpendicular to each other, their cross product is maximum. If two vectors are parallel to each other, their cross product is minimum. We have checked that out. Two non-zero vectors A and B are parallel if and only if theta is equal to 0 or pi. We are talking about non-zero vectors. We are not talking about null vectors, okay? These two vectors are parallel only if theta is 0 or pi, okay? In either case, what will happen? Sine theta will be 0. So, two vectors are parallel if sine theta is 0. So, what will happen? In this case, the magnitude of A cross B will be 0 and A cross B will be equal to null vector. Okay, this is basically zero vector. This is not simply zero. You can write it as zero n hat or zero vector. The cross product cannot be written as a scalar. You cannot mention it as simple zero. Okay, either you have to write it as zero vector or zero n hat. This is telling us about the magnitude of cross product. It could be written as a scalar, but this cross product cannot be mentioned as a scalar. It should be mentioned as a vector. So, A cross B is equal to zero vector. If two non-zero vectors are parallel to each other, then their sine of angle between them is either zero. Okay. So, theta will be either zero or 180 degrees. Okay. So, if we check out the geometrical interpretation of the cross product. What is geometric interpretation? Let's check it out. The geometric interpretation of cross product can be seen from this figure. You can check it out. We are having a cross product of two vectors, a vector A and vector B. Both are joined from their tails. You can see that we have drawn a parallelogram over here. We have drawn a vector parallel to vector B and we have drawn a vector parallel to vector A over here. And this B sine theta is basically the perpendicular component of vector B. Okay, so what we can see over here, if A and B are represented by arrows with the same initial point, then they determine a parallelogram with base A, altitude B sine theta, and area A is equal to AB sine theta. You can see over here that we are having a parallelogram over here with, we are having a parallelogram with base A. Base is vector A, its altitude is B sine theta. Okay, this parallelogram is having a base vector A, its altitude is having B sine theta. So area of parallelogram, oh, we know that base multiplied by height. Okay, so this base multiplied by height, A B sine theta, isn't it the magnitude of the cross product? So area of the parallelogram is equal to magnitude of the cross product. So what we can say that the area of this whole parallelogram gives us the magnitude of the cross product. This is the geometric interpretation of cross product, that if we are having two vectors and we are drawing the parallelogram from those two vectors, then area of that parallelogram will simply give us the magnitude of cross product of those two vectors. Okay, is that clear? That if we talk about the length or magnitude of the cross product, A cross B is equal to the area of parallelogram determined by A and B. Okay, so this is geometric interpretation, that the length or magnitude of cross product A cross B is equal to area of parallelogram determined by A and B. We have proved it with the formula. Okay, you have seen it over here with the formula, that base into height, it is giving us the magnitude of cross product. So area of this parallelogram is equal to magnitude of the cross product. Okay, so you can see over here, if you are having two vectors, vector A and vector B, and we are drawing its parallelogram, parallel vectors of A and B, this is giving us a parallelogram. So area of this parallelogram is equal to the magnitude of A cross B. Area of this parallelogram is equal to magnitude of A cross B. This is geometric interpretation of cross product. Okay, again you can see the same thing, that if we are having two vectors, vector A and vector B, then this area of parallelogram is equal to magnitude of cross product. If we are going to find out area of this parallelogram, then this will give us the magnitude of cross product, or if we are going to find out the magnitude of cross product, this will give us the area of parallelogram formed by these two vectors. Okay, so we can find out area of parallelogram by the cross product. Okay, next, check out that cross product is non-commutative. Dot product was commutative in nature. A dot B was equal to B dot A, but this is not the case with cross product. Let's see how. As the cross product of two vectors A and B is given as, we know this is the formula for cross product, A cross B is equal to A B sine of theta and hat. Okay, A cross B is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B sine of angle between them with normal vector direction of the A cross B. Okay, so if we say that we are having two vectors over here, vector A and vector B, magnitude of A cross B, it is equal to A B sine theta. Okay, magnitude of A cross B is magnitude of A multiplied by component of B perpendicular to A. That will give us A B cos theta, A B sine theta. Okay, if we are finding out magnitude of B cross A, if we are first finding B and then A, then what will happen? Magnitude of B multiplied by component of perpendicular component of A on B, that will again give us B A sine theta. Magnitude is same, B A sine theta. A cross B and B cross A are having same magnitude, but what about direction? Direction of A cross B, find it out. If we are using right hand rule to find out the direction of A cross B, I told you it is a different thing. If you are talking about A cross B, then we have to start curling fingers of our right hand from A, and we will curl the fingers toward B in the direction of rotation. We will curl the fingers of right hand from A towards B. That will give us the thumb, which is giving us the direction of resultant, upward. Okay, direction of A cross B is upward. What about B cross A? Now what we will do, we will place our right hand along B. We will place our right hand along B, and our palm should be towards A. Okay, our palm should be towards A. We will curl the fingers from B towards A. You can see that thumb is now in the downward direction. You can see over here, if we are placing our right hand along B and we are curling our fingers in the direction of A, the thumb will be directing in the downward direction. So if A cross B and B cross A are having opposite direction, then how they could be equal? They cannot be equal. Okay, so we can say that B cross A is equal to minus A cross B, because their direction is opposite. This negative sign is telling us that the direction of A cross B and B cross A is opposite to each other. So these are anti-commutative, these are not commutative. Okay, commutative law does not hold for cross product. A cross B is not equal to B cross A because their magnitude is same, but their direction is opposite. And for complete specification of a vector, magnitude as well as direction, both are important. If both are same, then those vectors are equal, otherwise they are not equal. And in this case, magnitude of A cross B and B cross A is same, but their direction is opposite. So what is there? The direction of A cross B is upward, the direction of B cross A is downward. So if resultant is C, let's say, then A cross B is equal to C and B cross A is minus C. Okay, so this right hand rule is basically telling us about the direction of resultant vector, which is opposite in both cases. For A cross B, it is upward in this case, and for B cross A, it is downward in this case. Okay, we have to curl the fingers from, we will start curling the fingers from vector which is written first, and we will curl our fingers towards the second vector. And erected thumb will tell us about the direction of resultant. Okay, in this case, we will place our right hand, we will curl the fingers towards A, from B towards A, and thumb will be in downward direction in this case. Okay, so what we can say that vector product or cross product is non-commutative. So the vector product is not commutative unlike scalars. The order in which the vectors are multiplied is important. So it is important that whether we are writing it as A cross B or B cross A, because A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. Okay, commutative law is not holding in this case. You can see over here in this figure, you can draw this figure to tell about the direction that if you are having two vectors A and B, then A cross B in this direction and B cross A is in this direction, and don't forget to put vector signs. Okay, so if we are checking out how we are going to multiply the unit vectors, we have done it for scalar product, we have done it in detail. We can do it in the same way for cross product as well. We can put I hat cross I hat is equal to magnitude of I hat into I hat sine of angle between the two multiplied by the vector direction. Okay, you can do that. You can do all those calculation for the cross product as well. You can find out the cross product of unit vectors as well. But there is an easy way. If we take cross product of standard unit vectors I hat, j hat and k hat, what we can do, we can simply, if you're going to learn that, because the answer is different in this case, we can simply draw this circle. It is drawn in such a way, you can see that its direction is clockwise. Okay, I hat, j hat, k hat. We have drawn a circle and we have given arrows over here, I hat, j hat, k hat. Just draw this circle, check this out. Okay, if we are going to find out the cross product, you can see I hat and j hat. If we are going to take cross product between I hat and j hat, I hat cross j hat, this will give us the result k hat. Okay, I hat cross j hat is equal to k hat. If we are going to multiply j hat with k hat, it will give us result I hat. J hat into k hat is equal to I hat. If you are going to multiply k hat with I hat, that will give us result j hat. We are moving in the direction of circle. Okay, k hat into I hat will be equal to j hat. See, we are having this resultant. What about if we are multiplying the vectors in opposite direction? If we are multiplying j hat with I hat, opposite to the direction of flow of circle, then what will happen? J hat cross I hat will be equal to minus k hat. Okay, j hat into I hat is equal to minus k hat. Similarly, I hat into k hat is equal to minus j hat. Okay, and k hat into j hat is equal to minus I hat. So if we are moving in the direction of circle, positive unit vectors result is there. If we are moving opposite to the direction of circle, negative sign will be there. You can prove all these identities by putting the values I hat cross j hat, all these values in the basic formula. A cross b is equal to ab sine of theta into n hat. By keeping this in mind, that if you are multiplying I hat with j hat, then normal vector n hat will become k hat, because k hat is perpendicular to both I and j. Okay, if you are multiplying j and k, then normal vector will be I, because I hat is perpendicular to both j and k. Okay, you can prove those identities. But keep this in mind, that I hat cross j hat is not equal to j hat cross I hat. Okay, you can see over here, I hat cross j hat is equal to k hat, and j hat cross I hat is equal to minus k hat. So again, it is proving this thing, that the cross product is not commutative. Okay, it is not commutative. If we talk about applications of cross product, the idea of cross product occurs often in physics as well as in daily life. If you are checking out the applications, opening a bottle cap, okay, see, if you are going to open the cap of a bottle, let's say we are having a water bottle, and if you are going to open that, then you have to curl the fingers of right hand around that cap of the bottle. You will see the direction of thumb will tell you about the direction of motion of cap. If you are opening the bottle cap, then you have to turn it in the anti-clockwise direction. And if you are going to close it, if you want the thumb pointing in the downward direction, if you want to close the cap of the bottle, then you have to turn the cap of the bottle in the clockwise direction. You can check this out. You can do this activity, okay? You can apply this cross product in opening a bottle cap. Opening a screw, again same thing, that if we are going to rotate the screw in the anti-clockwise direction, it will move outward, moves in the upward direction, it will be opened, okay? Otherwise it will be tightened. Tightening a nut, again following the same principle. Angular momentum, again example of cross product, R cross P. Okay, we will study these topics in detail. Angular momentum and torque, we will study these topics in detail. Torque is again giving us example of cross product, R cross F. Okay, so what is happening, all these are basically the applications of cross product, where we are applying the cross product. In particular, if we consider a force F acting on a rigid body at a point given by position vector R, we are just giving overview of torque, but we will study that torque in detail in one of the lectures which are upcoming, okay? So we will study that torque in detail. So right now we are just taking it as an example of cross product, that if we are applying a force which is given by a position vector R, for instance, if we tighten a bolt by applying a force to a wrench, you can see over here, this is an example that if you are applying force to a wrench, we produce a turning effect over here. This is R, position vector R, we are applying force in this direction, but you can see this, you can say we are producing a turning effect with the help of this wrench, okay? We are basically tightening this nut. Okay, it is moving in this direction. Okay, we are applying force over here in this direction, but it is moving along this direction because according to the result of cross product, the resultant produced will be perpendicular to both a plane containing both R and F. So the nut is moving in this direction. You can imagine this thing, that we are applying force here, but nut is moving in this direction. Okay, so this is due to the effect produced by cross product. Okay, that is basically the resultant of cross product. So the torque, tau relative to origin, is defined to be the cross product of position vector R and force vector. You can see here tau is the symbol of torque. Tau is equal to R vector cross F vector. Okay, so if we are taking cross product between R and F, this torque is basically the resultant vector which is perpendicular to both R and F. Okay, that's why the nut is moving in this direction instead of moving in the direction of force. Okay, the direction of the torque vector indicates the axis of rotation where the nut is rotating. That was all for today's lecture. Okay, so if we are going to check out that what is the ending of this lecture, I would like to end my lecture with this quote: none can steal your knowledge, but you should give it away to those who need it. Okay, no one can steal your knowledge, but you should spread it away, you should give it away to those who need it. That will increase your knowledge. So if someone is asking about help from you people, don't refuse. You have to spread the knowledge, that will increase your knowledge. That was all for today's lecture. Thank you so much. Best of luck.